There's no denying that we're always concerned about the future. What will happen tomorrow, the next day, or the next year? Like we were just having a good time in early 2020, and all of a sudden, the world shut down.
The coronavirus
outbreak. WHO is formally declaring millions across the globe.
In spite of all that, let's look at the grand scheme of things, because that's what you're here, right? Have you ever imagined what will happen in 4 billion years from now? It might sound like a long way to go, but on the cosmic level, it's only about a third of how long we have existed. In this video, we'll go through some of the major astronomical events that would probably happen over the course of 4 billion years. Before we look into the future, let's have a closer look into the past. The latest results from the NASA's WMAP satellite suggest that the universe is 13.75 billion years old. This is with a margin of error of 0.1 billion years, which makes it clear that trying to gaze into the cosmic crystal ball is always a challenging task. If it's hard to look into the past, it's sure going to be a foolhardy exercise to look into the future. On top of all that, the observable universe is approximately 93 billion light years in diameter. This means that it would take a beam of light to travel for 93 billion years from one side to the other. I'm just going to go out on a limb here to say that it's impossible to explore the whole universe in one lifetime for us living beings. But on the other hand, astronomers, with the help of the Hubble telescope, said that they can predict the future of stars and the universe. Not only for a few years, we're talking 10,000 years into the future. So how did they do it? Well, the astronomers used the Hubble telescope to map the motion of 100,000 stars in the Omega Centauri cluster. This was happening for over a period of 4 years. Omega Centauri itself is one of the star clusters in the Milky Way galaxy, and is about 15,000 light years away from Earth. This star cluster could be seen in the Saturn sky with the naked eye. In fact, the ancient astronomer Ptolemy even cataloged this as a single star. And fast forward centuries later, now with the Hubble telescope, astronomers know that it was in fact a compact cluster of stars, millions of them. And they move like a swarm of bees. So taking that data taken from 2002 until 2006, astronomers created a simulation of the star's motion. This was then used as a baseline to predict the future of motion of stars projected over the next thousands of years. Of course, there's a big uncertainty. Like, if this baseline is used for the far future, it should account for the second law of thermodynamics, that the entropy must rise over time for the next billions of years. Who knows if the baseline model still holds true in the far future? So with that in mind, please take the information presented in this video with a grain of salt. But before we go down the list one by one, I'm just gonna spoil what's gonna happen at the end of this video. It's this. Now let's sit back in our time machine, relax, and start our journey into the far future. In 10,000 years, the red supergiant star named Antares would explode into a supernova due to a shortage of hydrogen in its core. This explosion would be so big that it would be visible on Earth in daylight. In 15,000 years, Earth's axial tilt would be reversed. Because of this, the summer and winter would occur on the opposite side of our planet. Australia would have their first wintry Christmas for the first time in 20,000 years. But the last time Christmas happened here, there was no Christmas. Either way, this would also mean that the Northern Hemisphere would experience a more extreme weather due to a high percentage of land to sea ratio. In 20,000 years, Earth would face a supervolcanic eruption which would be life-threatening and could also wipe out the entire civilization. Imagine the Krakatoa eruption in 1800. Now multiply that by 1000 and you'd have that supervolcanic eruption. If, for example, the humankind could survive that, pretty much they would be back to the age with no technological development at all. In 100,000 years, due to the constant motion of stars in the Milky Way galaxy, many constellations in the sky would be non-visible. Some of them would have a complete change in their geometrical shape. The hypergiant star named VYEN would explode into a supernova, and the traces of its explosion would leave precious minerals, like gold and platinum, into deep space. In 500,000 years, currently there's a star named Wolf-Rayet WR104. I know, right? It's complicated. But in 500,000 years from now, it would explode into a supernova, which would produce a gamma ray burst, so powerful that it could remove biological life here on Earth. As a side note, when a star with a big enough core explodes into a supernova, its radiation releases gamma rays, so much power that these rays carry a million times more energy than any normal light. In 750,000 years, astronomers predict that an asteroid with a size of approximately 3,000 feet would strike the Earth's surface. The crater from this asteroid would be 250 miles in diameter. As a result of that, a disastrous fire would start, and sadly, the air would be unbreathable near the impact site. But there is a hope that mankind would have the technology to destroy the asteroid before reaching the Earth. Again, assuming that mankind is still around at that time. In 1 million years, you must have heard about a famous crater in Arizona. Yes, the one that has a diameter of 1,200 meters. Due to the erosion of Earth's surface, in 1 million years, it would completely flatten out. And no one from the 21st century would be able to recognize this site by this time. In 10 million years, by this time the moons of Uranus, Cressida and Desdemona would collide together due to the change in their elliptical path. In 50 million years, Mars would collide with Phobos, its moon. The impact would result in a lot of destructions of the planet, and it will also affect the orbital path of Mars around the Sun. In 100 million years, Earth is likely to be hit by an asteroid about 10 kilometers in size. This is similar to the collision that happened 65 million years ago and wiped out the dinosaurs. Perhaps this kind of asteroid impact does pay a visit to Earth every 165 million years. In 500 million years, a gamma ray burst would occur within 6,500 light years from Earth. The results would be deadly. The burst would be so powerful that it would destroy the ozone layer in a few seconds. Also, the radiation from the burst would stop the photosynthesis in plants, and eventually life from our planet would be wiped out again. In 1.5 billion years, the luminosity of the Sun would increase by about 10%. As a result of this, the average temperature on our planet would rise above 116 degrees Fahrenheit. But you might be thinking, it's not that hot, is it? Well, that is actually because we're talking about the average global land and ocean surface temperature. In March 2020, the average temperature of the Earth's surface was 2 degrees Fahrenheit. In 3 billion years, there are 1 in 100,000 chances that Earth would be ejected into deep space due to the continuous expansion of our universe. Also, there are 1 in 1.3 million chances of being captured by another star's gravity. In 4 billion years, anyone, anything, or any aliens alive at this time would witness the most spectacular event ever in the history of the night sky, a cosmic collision between the Milky Way galaxy and the Andromeda galaxy. Billions among billions of stars would get in contact through this collision. Many star systems would be born, and many would be gone. Maybe the result would produce habitable planets like Earth. And assuming that Earth would still survive that collision, our planet would be a part of a bigger system, a galaxy named Andromeda. We aren't really sure what else would change in the universe in the course of 4 billion years. The universe is so massive that it brings many possibilities within it. Who knows if humans are able to survive throughout this timeline? Maybe the technology would become so advanced that we're able to civilize a whole galaxy in the future. Or maybe our current understanding is so minuscule that we're not aware what the future might present. But at the end, it's the curiosity that makes us humans. If this video has been helpful in any way, don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell notification button to be notified for more curiosity videos like this. I'll see you again on the next Beyond Ideas videos.